Chapter 4,
Roadside Battle. Ike! I got to tell you something! Listen to this! Settle down, miss. It's too early for you to be yelling like that. Now what's going on? Soren's back! He just arrived! Really? That's odd. He wasn't supposed to return for a while yet. I know! I wonder why he's doing back so soon. It's probably nothing to worry about. I'll go and talk to him. Where is he? In the mess hall. I think he wanted to talk to Father. Right, I'll go check there. Troubling news indeed. Gather the troops. Yes, Commander. Ike, if you got time to waste, you got time to work. Get over to the briefing room. Yes, sir. Hey, what's going on around here? Bad news. Something big is happening, and we need to formulate a plan of action. Soren! Hello, Ike. Long time no see. I'm happy to see you're back. But what happened? I thought you were going to be studying for a while longer. It's a long story. What's the holdup? Get over here, now! Let's go. I'll fill you in later. You probably remember that Soren's been traveling with another mercenary group. Well, he's back now. And he has some unbelievable news. What news is that? It's Crimea and Daein. They've gone to war.
What?
War? It can't be! That's why I've called everyone here. Soren has some more information. Go ahead, Soren. All right. Take a look at this map. Ah, it's a map of Crimea. Quite detailed, it looks like. Yes, this is Melior, Crimea's capital, or THE Melior. Our base of operations is right about here. Everything started 3 years ago. I needed to do some research, so I went to the archives of Melior's Loyal Royal Library. Without warning, this crew is a terrible beast. Why would you absorb the air? Building was rocked by a tree. The Russian sun saw the wave after the wave of knights cavalry and blind warriors. Each clan listening at what was in it.
Daein army!
Nothing that has ever approached the scale of this attack. It was brutal and without warning. Daein lay the capital to waste. Never seen destruction on this scale before. A swift attack, devastating and brutal. A daring gambit indeed. But if it succeeds, I've already chosen my part. I'm gonna turn down the recorder volume a little bit. That should hopefully work. That's alright. Word of the war cannot have traveled far yet. We may well be the first ones to know of it out here. You did well to bring us this information, Soren. I know some risk was involved. It was nothing. Daein has invaded Crimea. We may be mercenaries, but this still affects us. What are we going to do? That's the question of the day. How do you see it, Titania? Crimea is the closest thing our company has to a homeland. The Crimean royal family and noble houses have been generous, providing us with many lucrative jobs. From a moral standpoint, as well as a business one, it's in our best interests to help Crimea. And you, Soren? I agree on one point. We are mercenaries. We are not Crimea's private militia. No coin has crossed our palm, so I think we should stay out of it. So you would have us sit and watch as Crimea is overrun? I would. Daein's troops are superior in both numbers and morale. The chances of a Crimean victory are slim indeed. But Crimea is ruled by King Ramon, who is known throughout the land for his wisdom. and his brother Duke Renning is said to possess peerless valor and courage. Daein may not find victory so easily. Valor and courage are for children's tales. In terms of military prowess, Daein's King Agenor is every bit Lord Renning's equal. Victory will hinge on troops, troop numbers, and supplies, and Daein is superior in both. I think the outcome is painfully obvious. Curse you, Sorin! Crimea is not doomed! If they can turn aside Daein's initial thrust and turn it into a test of endurance, with the Crimean army both demoralized and ill-prepared, they simply will not be able to hold out that long. Alright, that's enough. Both of you. I hear what you say. However, we must ascertain the current situation before we decide on any action. We'll send a scouting party to get a closer look at Melior. Ike, I want you in charge of this. Assemble your men and get going. What? Me? Titania will accompany you, advisor. Commander, you must be joking! He's just a boy! He's had barely more than a taste of battle! What do you expect a whelp like him to accomplish? Ah, Xenon, since you're so concerned, you can go as well. Wait, it's not what I asked! Who else? Gatry, Reese, and Sorin. What should you do? Hold the wait, why do you want me? That was an order. Get moving. There's no time to waste. Yes, sir. Titania, come on after me. I want you to get life's direction. Understood. Yes, sir. Ike, wait up! What? Here, this is for you. The Regal Sword. Sword? Did you get it? For father. Somebody come and give it to me. It's beautiful. This is the first sword we got that was a hand-me-down from somebody, isn't it? That's great. But if Grail wanted him to have the sword, wouldn't that technically qualify as a hand-me-down? Yeah. Well, be careful. Oh, and bring me a souvenir. Something nice. I've never been to Melior before. Miss, I'm not going on vacation. Sheesh. So here are the paths to the capital. Feeling alright, Ike? You haven't said a word in quite some time. I don't understand what my father's doing. Why put a new recruit like me in charge of something so important? You're going to succeed him as our commander. Don't you think he wants you to know how to lead? Me? I don't know. I'm capable. Indeed, if I am, that day's a long way off. I'm not experienced. I'm not so sure. I see a young man on the forest. Commander Grail is a great man, but I think you'll be every bit as good. In time, you might even surpass him. Subtle foreshadowing. Don't be ridiculous. It's just my opinion. You need not pay it any mind. Yet, if you fear your own weakness, why not take this chance to go out and better yourself? That'll be more in keeping with your personality. I suppose you're right. How things look over there, Sorin. Same as here. There are corpses strewn everywhere. There are quite a lot of them, especially when you consider how far we are from the capital. Are they Crimean? Judging by the armor, the vast majority of the dead are Daein soldiers. So Crimea has the upper hand? Just the opposite, I think. The Crimean soldiers were members of the Imperial Guard. That means King Ramon, or another member of the royal family, was on the move when Daein soldiers fell on them. Could it have been Lord Renning? No. As long as the Crimean army still draws breath, Lord Renning will not cede their command. Perhaps another member of the court. We've got Daein soldiers moving in at our location, and they don't look happy. You there! Who are you? What are you doing here? No one you need. You're armed. Heed me. Drop your weapons and surrender. Act quickly or else. Listen to me, fool. You're making a mistake. We're not... not going to cooperate, eh? Ready our weapons, men. Move in and kill them all. Fools. Getting caught in some skirmish is not part of the plan. But they're obviously not one of those tools. Royal mercenaries, get ready to fight. see how you handle the role of captain. Well, Grey Orders, boy. You do as you say, so unless you hurry up and spit it out. I know, I'm thinking. Give me a little, will you, Shinon? Useless. You better let me miss the summer testing well. You are the biggest a-hole in this game. Oh my gosh. So now we're dealing with the Daein army at long last. These are going to be your main enemies throughout the game. And you can easily identify them by their black cloud. But nothing not much special. The boss is my engine, and he drops the javelin. He's not too tough with bots because of that, but he can easily pull off some of your enemies and units from bots. You're best off taking a heavily defensive position, including having Gatry and Titanium take most of the enemies. A good idea would be to unequip Titanium, have her in front of a bunch of units, that way she takes some damage but doesn't outright defeat her. We also got a new unit, Soren. Mages work a bit differently in this game compared to the other Fire games. In this game, all wind elements have their own rank. They also have their own magic strategy. If I have it in the right direction, I believe it's... I think it's Thunder is good against Fire, Fire is good against Wind, Wind is good against Thunder. I don't know if I have that backwards, but that's how it works. Soren is a Wind Mage. Wind Mage is very light and very easy to wield, especially hit rate-wise, because it has such a high hit rate. However, it's weak. Very, very weak. And even the fact that it's good against flyers doesn't help it too much in the long run. Soren has pretty good magic and speed, and he comes with a reliable amount of skill. However, considering he's a mage, he's very frail, so you do not want him on the front lines. You want him to do things like that. He comes with the skill Adept. His skill percent chance of attacking twice, basically, for any given attack. So it was basically a mini brave weapon. I'm trying to think about how I want to set Gatry, because he's going to be my main focus. I know Shinon is good with Asia, but that doesn't mean much in the face of Orange. This is one of those maps where the first two turns can be difficult, but if you think around it right, it should be too hard. In the back as usual. The win if you defeat the boss, lose if I die. Standard protocol. Alright, let's crush us some Daeins. Oh. That's fast. Some of these soldiers are already starting to feel rather tough. They're not your average bandits. You just love being loyal, don't you? My mind and something. pretty good for this turn. Even though I'm actually going to heal. Well, basically, he's restored to get the kill. Glad Ike's dodging these things because of his lack of defense! This may or may not be a problem. Clear you out of the way. Alright. I don't want to do this. If I keep Ike where he is, all the soldiers are going to attack him and kill him. HP, strength, skill, speed, luck. Everything surrounding Sword and will kill him this time. Since this guy is low on health, he's probably gonna run off, so I'd rather take you out of the way first. This will keep Sora protected from all but the archer. Though knowing an archer's AI, they'll probably go after Sora. I just want to check that Sora is just in case he didn't come back to you. Oh, no, he didn't run back. Kind of surprised, too. Oh. Okay. Oh, that's right, I forgot to go over the Radiant Sword. It's basically the rapier for Ike. It's effective against knights and cavalry. Though, weapon effectiveness in this game only doubles in mine, so it's not that big of a game. Either way, it's mostly. Cut you down to size. Thank you. He has enough HP. Don't expect main mage to get any strength. This is that's more sword on. Stronger than the iron sword, so if you feel like you need to use it, just remember this is the only regal sword you have in the game, so you don't want to use it too much. Please get defense, Ike. magic. Double? Unbelievable.
Side of that thicket. A wounded soldier, perhaps? Let's go have a look. Careful now. Oh no. Did you find anything, Reese? It's a woman. Leave her. We shouldn't get involved in matters that don't concern us. I think this lady looks important, Soren. Oh. Thank goodness. It looks like she's really fainted. Right. Better take her with us for now and make sure she's alright. Give me a hand, will you, Reese? Of course. I don't like this.